Namami Mudanvagam. Music is the universal language of mankind, where words fail, music speaks. A very good afternoon to one and all present here on such an auspicious occasion. On behalf of Fine Arts Association and Vasudeva Kutumbakam of SCSVMV, I take this opportunity to welcome you all for the lecture demonstration on an insight into Carnatic music through Veena by Smt Revathi Sadasivam, an A-grade artist, All India Radio. It gives me an immense pleasure to welcome our Honorable Vice Chancellor of our Mahavidyalaya, Professor Dr. S.V. Raghavan. I feel honored to welcome Veena Nadamani, an A-grade artist, Smt Revathi Sadasivam, who is the disciple of vocal and Veena from late Sri Anantaram Iyer and late Srimati Shanbhagavalli of Sri Guru Guga Gana Vidyalaya, Kolkata, who belong to the Sishya Parambara of Sri Muthuswami Dikshitar. We welcome you all, ma'am. On behalf of our SCSVMV, I welcome Srimati Premalata, Sishya of Srimati Revathi Sadashiv. We welcome you, ma'am. I am very happy to welcome all the faculty members and students of our SCSVMV. Once again, I welcome you all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Now, I request Ms. Sai Lakshmi from final year to address our chief guest. As they say, music is a message from God and musicians are the messengers. Today, we have one such talent among us, Mrs. Revathi Sadasivam, ma'am. She has been felicitated and bestowed with multiple awards and titles like Lalita Kalasuma from Sri Rama Lalita Kala Mandira, Bengaluru, Veena Nadamani from Kanchi Mutt. She has also won first prize in Veena competitions conducted in Mumbai, the Music Academy in Madras, and the All India Youth Festival, Kolkata. Ma'am has also performed in the National Program and SRSN for Doordarshan in various TV, including SVBC, Sri Shankara, and Udaya. She has also performed in Thiruvayur Tyagaraja Aradhana, Adipuram Festival, and in leading institutes and sabhas. She has also conducted numerous music workshops and lecture demonstrations for Veena conferences all over India. I take it as a great privilege and honor to be welcoming such a gifted and accomplished artist to give a lecture demonstration on an insight into Carnatic music through Veena, organized by the Fine Arts Association of SCSVMV. A very warm welcome, ma'am.
Namaskaram. Good evening to all of you. I'm extremely happy to be here and very much thankful for the university for providing me this platform. And very also encouraging to see. I don't think it's very encouraging to see so many of you present today in this library hall for this presentation. I don't know how many of you are Carnatic music students. Many of you may be interested, and many of you must be learning. Some of you must be professional singers. I'm sure it's a mixed group. I'll try my best to, you know, keep you inspired in Carnatic music. So today's topic that I have chosen is insights into Carnatic music through the Veena, because I wanted to showcase the Veena, which is a very ancient instrument, and Carnatic music can be understood better with an instrument. So I just want only one thing from you: whether should I talk about the Carnatic music first and then play a small, you know, few songs later, or should I first play and then talk? That's up to you. You can give me a choice. First talk. Sure. Otherwise, I won't have this mic here. That's why. Be knowing that Carnatic music is a very, very vast subject. It's a part of Indian classical music. Indian classical music has got two divisions. One is the Carnatic type and the Hindustani type. So even a day or two is not enough to completely cover the aspects of Carnatic music. But there are some important aspects, integral part of Carnatic music, like you must be knowing the swaram, what we call the saptaswaras, then the raga, talam. So those things I'll be touching upon. So to understand that, we have to understand why Carnatic music is also called Karnataka Sangeetam. That's an ancient, Karnataka Sangeetam is a very ancient type of music. So why is it so ancient, and how ancient can it be? It is said that a music emanated from the Samavedas. You must be knowing, when they recite the Samaveda, there is a certain musical tune attached to that. So they say that the music, all the swaras, came from the Samaveda. Samaveda started with one or two swaras, and it ultimately become seven swara, which we call the Saptaswara in our music. So it is a very divine art form. And one more thing about it is, we have to go to some of the Kritis. Today, for everything, we need some proof. If I say that, you know, it is supposed to have come from Shiva or Saraswati or whatever, you may disagree, or you may think, okay, that's given in the books. But the saintly composers, the very good Vagyakaras, like Tyagaraja Swami, Muthuswami Dikshadar, Shama Sastri, they being the Trinity, Purandaradasa, all of these Vagyakaras who have lived in the 18th and 17th century, 15th century onwards, in all, most of their kritis, they have talked about the saptaswaras, then is like a nada. It's the sound. It's not exactly sound. It is nada coming from the divine. So Tyagaraja Swami in one of his kritis says, Satyo jatadi panchavaktraja sarigama padani saptaswara. So it is given in a kriti, nada tanumanisham in the raga chittaranjani. So you can go through these, whenever I say these examples, you can note it down and Google and find out what is the full meaning of the whole song. I'm only touching the parts of it. So that is a proof to say that the five heads of Shiva, from there came the Saptaswaras. So that is what he means in this kriti. Saptaswaras form the basis for the Carnatic music. For any music, you need the swaras. Swaras put together form a melody. Like Sa Ri Ga Ma Pa Da Ni has got different types. When it is the Ri Rishabham, when I say Sa Ri Ga Ma Pa Da Ni, it is Sajjam Rishabham Gandharam. That is the full form of it. So each one has its own types. Like for example, there are three Rishabhams, Ri 1, Ri 2, Ri 3. So each will lead to a different raga. So many melodies are created. Melody or raga is the same. Okay, so we need these swaras to make a raga. That is why it is very important. And before I come to the raga, saptaswaras, the origin again is from nature. Each swara has got its origin from the birds and animals found in the nature. For example, the sajjam or the sa is like the cry of the peacock. Then the nishadam or the knee is the trumpeting of the elephant. And the gandharam is like that of the bleating of the goat. So in this way, always our music has come from the divine. It is very close to the nature, and everything has come from the nature. For example, you must be knowing instruments like flute were found in the nature from the bamboo. When the bamboo trees, were making sound through the holes, that instrument called flute came. We discovered that. Everything is natural, and like the Veena, it is made up of the jackwood tree. And everything about it is very natural. So even the saptaswaras, everything we got from the animals and birds. Now, coming to the ragas. Why raga is so important in Carnatic music or in any form of music, raga is important? Because the raga changes. It's not always one raga that we talk about. It is thousands of ragas. So that's why you hear different types of songs. Say I play 4 or 5 songs, you will find that each raga is different. You may not know in what way it is different, why it is different, but they are different. That what is responsible for that change is the swaras which are formed. So within that 7 swaras, we get thousands of ragas. Raga form the soul of the music. It has got the power to move you. Whenever you listen to any melody without knowing it is Carnatic, Hindustani or film or anything, something moves you. That melody is called the raga. You can, as a student, find out what is the name of the raga, what is it made up of and things like that. But even without knowing, that melody touches our heart, and that is the raga. So it has got the bhava and the soul in it. Now, ragas can be understood well through the Veena. So here I will have to demonstrate a few things for you to understand. I take a basic raga called Shankarabharanam. As I told you, gamakas are something which add beauty to the same swaras. So now I played, what are the swaras found in Shankarabharanam? I have played. Now let me add some gamakas. So now you see the complexion has changed, isn't it? So there are some compositions which are in the flat mode, and there are some compositions which are in the gamaka mode. So suppose I play, which you must have learned, for example. This is a notaswaram. You are supposed to play the Shankarabharanam in this flat way. Now let me play some kriti in Shankarabharanam, so you may find a complete change of complexion. Gamaka based ragam. So without gamakas, there are some compositions which you play like that, and with gamaka, what happens to the raga? So this is how we say that gamakas are very important in Carnatic music. Like this, there are panchadasha gamakas, means 15 types of gamakas. This can be what I played here. I'm just oscillating one note from here to there. There is some other gamakas which are going from up, like that, coming back. It's called the jaru gamaka, which goes from here up and coming back also. In this way, there are 15 gamakas, which are very important, and they can be demonstrated very well through the veena. Even the vocalist, when they learn and the teacher says, you use this gamaka, they'll be confused. But you can play it in the veena and find out what the teacher actually meant by saying, I'm emphasizing the re. That is called nok. That is, different names are given. Now do oscillation. Then make it like this. Go slide, come back. So many things are there. In every raga, you have to add some kind of gamakas and make it sound better. So these are the pancha dasha gamakas that add soul to the raga. Again, why in veena it is very important to know Carnatic music is another thing. Say, for example, I take a ragam in which this is one melody. So just note the ga, the gandharam. Ga, it is like that. Immediately the gamaka, when I give, the complexion is changing. Here what I am doing is, the frequency of the note is also changing. The frequency. Those who must be reading physics and all must be knowing about the sound, etc. So this is the same place. You can increase it and decrease it. How do I decrease it? I will go to the one note below that and decrease it. I'll play the same thing here and make it sound very less. I'll play on this. I'll make it sound more. But actually, they both are the same gandhara. So this is possible to demonstrate on a veena. Whereas in voice, we can say, you sing it a little less, you sing it a little more, you can do like this, you can do, you have to imagine, you have to think, you can't see. But in veena, you can clearly see, you can probably play and see for yourself and understand what it is meant. So this, the frequency, the pitch intervals, all these can be demonstrated in the veena. I hope up to this, it was kind of clear to you whatever I'm saying? Yeah. Next we come, then even Navarasas, I told you that some emotions are created by way of raga. So ragas are very, very important. Emotions are created by the rasa. Every raga will have an emotion. So that also to be demonstrated. So this is a Gambhira rasa. Don't you feel, I mean, can you hear it like that? Say, suppose in those days, the drama, when they give background music, suppose a king is, the arrival of a king is shown by some music. So that Gambhiram should be there. Or the Veera rasa, you can say that. So that rasa, this raga, what I played is called Atana. And this raga has the ability to bring out that Veera rasa. Or even this this one. So these are Veera rasa. So these some ragas are attached to this rasa. Now we go to completely a different kind of rasa. Be the emotion of this raga? Anybody can answer? Meditative kind of raga. Okay, this raga name is Sama. It has got the Shanta rasam. Suppose you want to meditate, you can use this raga and that mood of meditation comes. So this is the Shanta rasa, then Veera rasa. Like this, you know about the Navarasas, different types of rasa, Hasya rasa, being very happy, and Raudra rasa. So many others are there. So in this way, Veena also brings out the emotion content of the raga very clearly. Now we go to the talam. Talam is the most integral part of Shruti. Talam are very important in Carnatic music. In Veena, it is so important because this is one instrument that has got the talam here itself. The talam is very much part of the instrument. The talam which you put here and sing in Carnatic music, that beat can be kept here. So whenever we put the beat, that same tala, we are going to use it in the tala string given. Can you imagine in violin, we cannot put it. In flute also, it is not possible. In Veena, it is possible because it is part of the instrument. So this is a unique thing about Veena. You can keep the beat as you are performing. And another thing is, even when I'm playing a melody, like a raga, when I'm playing, just to add color to that. Add some color to the melody whenever I am doing a raga alapana. So there also it is used. Then the most important thing is the thanam part. in Carnatic music, ragam is one, thanam is one, then swara kalpana is one. These all come in the manodharma aspect. So thanam is very much suitable for veena playing. Thanam is like the rhythmic representations of swaras. These are all patterns of swaras which are used in thanam. The word thanam is also having some significance in the sense it gives you happiness. Anantam, anantam are the syllables used when you sing the thanam and play the thanam. Next, in thanam also we can have different varieties, like again, they have taken the actions of the birds and animals as the pattern to form the thanam. For example, if I say gaja thanam, which animal does it mean? Gaja thanam. Yes, so you know that. So elephant gait is very majestic. It's very slow, and very slow and steady it comes. So the gaja thanam, I'm trying my best to do that. Slowness is called the gaja thanam. In this way, there are many types of thanam, around 10 types. Mayura thanam, then the ashwa thanam, like the horse. So these always we have compared our music coming from nature, from birds and the animals. So it is very interesting. Whenever you listen to a Carnatic music concert, try to imagine what is that sound, how this pattern is made. We can even make for thanam patterns from the Vedas also, how they say the Vedas. Also is like the Veda. So we can take innumerable things, sounds from the nature, something around you, and you can make your own music. Next, we go on to the Shruti part. Shruti Mata Layav Pita, they say. Shruti is very, very important. And that is the pitch with which we are singing. This, what I'm playing, it's got a regular pitch. What they sang now, the prayer that had another pitch, the what is a Shruti for a male can be different for a female. For a young girl, it can be more, it can be less. As we grow old, our Shruti may come down. So there are different types of pitches, and we have to be very careful that we align with the Shruti and then give a performance. That is very important. In Veena, we find the octaves. So when you talk about Shruti, the octaves, the broadly, there are three octaves. Can anybody tell music students what is a three types of sthayi here? Octaves, name of the octaves? Correct, very good. So mandara, madhya, tarasthayi. So madhya sthayi, when we say madhya is the middle, that is here. This is the madhya sthayi. Tarastai is the upper octave, going beyond this. It's done. Then, next again we come back to Madhya. That's A. This all the three plus Atitarastai and Anumandrastai, all these are possible in the Veena, which is not even possible in the human voice to sing up to this Sa or go beyond this. It won't be heard, or it is very high, difficult to reach. So these are the possibilities in the Veena. So can somebody tell me what we have discussed so far? On what aspects? Raga, Talam, Swara. Okay, good. No, I wanted to know if it is too, I'm putting all of you to sleep or? Okay. The most important thing is the composition in a Carnatic music. No, what do you play the Carnatic music? Carnatic music la enna vasipom? Enna vasikirathu? So it is the composition. In a, the Vagyakaras have made some songs called Kritis. That is what we play on the Veena. There is one thing you must remember in Carnatic music, there is no separate composition for instrument and separate composition for vocalist. It is not like that. We have to play the same thing. So far, not many people have done, but definitely there are many instrumentalists who have tried out their own compositions which suits the instrument. As I told you, I want to play this octave. And there is no composition which goes beyond this Sa. So I make my own composition and I can do that. So that I use this instrument, all the space given here, I can use it. So I can make a composition and do. But otherwise, as a rule, we generally play the compositions which are already present and made by the, I told you, the Trinity have done and many other composers. So mostly the vocal base comes to the Veena or any other instrument also. Now when doing this, it is very difficult for a Vainika. A person who plays the Veena is called a Vainika. It's difficult for them because it is not just a script is given and you start playing. It is not like that. You have to match the words as much as possible and bring it on the Veena. It has to sound to you like that. So you have to know the Sahityam or the words and then plan and prepare the song. So it is two things for you. One, you have to learn how to sing, how to put the Talam, where is this word coming, where do I put the Talam here. Everything has to be learnt. So it is like learning a vocal and then again putting it in the instrument and then learning. So it is a tough job for the Vainikas and you have to do more practice to get it on the instrument. Now there is versatility in the Veena playing. When I say versatility, we say the compositions can be very small, like a Geetam, Varaveena, Mridupani, like that. Then the Shakti, Saita, Ganapatim, those are notes, notus varams, that is easy. Then slowly it becomes bigger and bigger, the songs become bigger and bigger and slower, and the talas become so complicated. You have to understand the talas, and so as the student learns, you have to really practice a lot and understand the script very well and then play the Veena. So you have to as you start playing, it becomes very tough. But there is another possibility. You may ask that in Veena, is it only possible to play the Carnatic music? But you must have heard or seen that people do many other music also in Veena. Can you tell anything else apart from Carnatic music played in the Veena? Have you heard? So film music. Film music, Veena is used. Rajesh Vaidya is now presently doing that, But you please go to, you Google and see in the YouTube, all the old film music. All the old film music that existed, I think 1960s, 70s or something. The main character, say the hero, heroine, she always sings with the Veena only in the hand. I'm not saying how she's playing, but I'm saying she always has a Veena in her hand and conveys her message, whether it is crying or, you know, she's in a very good mood or whatever it is, she has a Veena in her hand. She plays. So K.R. Vijaya, you must have seen. Even that, so some movies I have listed out, even I am yet to see them, because nowadays we don't get to see those movies. I think that Meendum Kokila, that film, Sri Dev, she knows. So that is one thing. And then I also found out Kalaimagal Kai Porule, that's one, this one, Vasanta Maliga, it is listed. So these are some probably hit movies, and even in the mythological movies, you know, Sampurna Ramayana or something, where Ravana plays the Veena and things like. So Veena has the existence even before we even know about it. So it's, I told you, it is coming from the divine and all that. So that is how it has been that popular. Suddenly it has lost its place. And then again, it has been now replaced by the technical things like keyboard and rhythm pad and things like that. Natural instruments have been replaced by different types of, because they are able to produce the sound of a Veena without a Veena. Sound of a sitar with the press of a button. So these are the things that is happening now, but this was in existence even before. So it is as ancient. And the place of the Veena was so important even in the film music. Then, even ghazals are played in the Veena, jazz, pop music, whatever you want can be played. But how do you play? Can everything be played in the same instrument with the same type of tonality? It is not possible. They change the acoustics of the Veena a little bit, and with the help of the mic and other kind of sound system, they can produce the type of sound they want from the Veena itself. So that is how I think Rajesh Vaidya sir plays, because it, the pitch may be different and the acoustically it may be a little different. A little changes you have to do and then you get that sound. It also produces the sound of guitar and other things. Sometimes you don't see the instrument. You may think you are listening to mandolin or guitar or something, but it is being played in the Veena because they are using that kind of a sound box. Now the Veena, when I'm talking about the Veena of the olden times, let me also touch upon the very old Veenas, where you must have seen the very, very old Veenas. Where? Museums? Temples? In the temple sculptures you would have seen a lady standing with the Veena, and the Veena looks like one kind of vertical lute, they say, or yard, they say. So the Makara yard, Kinnara Veena, so many names are given for that Veena. It has got, Veenas have evolved from so many years, like single string Veena is called Ekatantri, Shatatantri Veena, 100 strings Veena, and so on. Makara yard means it is in the form of a crocodile. Then Rudra Veena, there are many types of Veena which has evolved. So Veena, when I take up a subject, just Veena, we can discuss all those things. Now what I am handling now, what is this present type of Veena called? What is this called? Saraswati Veena. Finally, it got the name Saraswati Veena. After undergoing lot of changes. So when I'm talking about the Veena, I'll talk about the how it is. This is made from jackwood tree, okay? So it can be made from one single wood. It is called Ekanda Veena, made from one single. Suppose this kind of thing is there. You can see one attachment here. That means it is made two parts. This resonator part is different. This is dandi, we say. This thing is different. And this is called the yali. This is why this is like this. Many people have asked me, children also who come for class, they are kind of scared of this. They say the dragon or something. So it is, in Tamil we say Yali, Yali Mukam. This Yali, if you find, again you go to the temples, everywhere this one face, you know, is kept right on. Yeah, yeah. It is not connected with the music. To give the shape, it has been turned like this. Otherwise, it will be cut like this. It will be just standing like this. So given a curve for a balance of the instrument to make it look like that, that shape. So it is like that. And again, why that Yali, that one Asura face or something is given in the temples when you just enter? Why? Because I think that we say, no, Drishti or something. So, or, you know, make people scared. So, yes, so for that, for this such a beautiful instrument, this gives the Drishti balance for this instrument, probably. And they have done this. Then there is, I heard some other artist telling a story saying that there was an Asura, he was troubling Brahma. And then Brahma brought in Saraswati and told her, see, he's troubling me. So she started playing the Veena and she controlled him and put him here in the Veena. He's controlled in the Veena, in the sound of the Veena, with the sound she could control him. And he became all right, very soft person or something. So as a reminder, she kept him with her only in the Veena. So these are all some stories which are found in the Puranas. Like we say, the Chikkal Singara Velavan and all, you know, the in Tiruchendur, the Rakshasas, the demons have become peacock and one has become the, so the same way. So that Rakshasa must have come here. And what it says is that Ahankaram should go. So for that, put him in place. So these are the ways they talk about the Yali. Actually, that doesn't give any sound value to this, but we are more interested in that. So the sound adding value is this. This is the resonator. This is a big kodam. It's called kodam. And there is a top. This is a covering. You can take out this. This is a kind of covering. So this whole thing is empty and hollow. That's why it is light. You can carry like this. So they take a wood and completely take out the wood of it and make it like a open pot kind of thing, and then cover with this, and then fix this wax made out of beeswax and metal frets. So 24 frets are there, and we get all these swaras and octaves and etc. are made of this. And these are called biridai, or the in English it's called pegs. And then there is a bridge, and this is the nagapasham, which holds or binds the instrument strings. Four strings are there. As I told you, the anusarani, panchamam, anusarani, anu panchamam. All these are the four strings, and then the thala strings are here. And the for the thala string, there is another small bridge which goes over it. And you increase or decrease the shruti according to this. If you have any question, you can ask me. And this is again another resonator. Before, it used to be made out of pumpkin. Dry the pumpkin, and it's called the gourd. That used to be there. Then that, after some time, it used to tear and it used to fall off because it's organic totally. So that got replaced by tin, aluminium, now fiberglass, and so many other materials. So that it's very sturdy. But this also gives resonance to the Veena. And the balance and how we, it helps us to keep the way we want to play. So these are the things. Again, Veena is compared to Manushya, our human body, they say. These frets represent the spine. So it is regarded very priceless and very divine. Now, apart from this, we can talk a lot about the concert format. How concert, what do you do for a concert? The formatting, you start with some certain ragas, end with Mangala ragas, Then in between there is a main piece, and you start with the Ganesha Kriti and so on. Again, after formatting, duration of the concert. The duration can be 2.5 to 3 hours normally. Otherwise, it can be like how it's going to be today, not even 20 minutes or 10 minutes. So accordingly, we have to play in that. So we shorten the ragas or something. But if you start with a varnam, you end with a mangalam. In between, you can play some manodharma ragams, then big compositions of the Vagyakaras. Suppose I have come to Kanchipuram, I try to sing a song on Kamakshi, Ekamresha, like that, depending on the purpose. And then you go to Tilana. These are all light pieces. Then Padam, Javalis, there are many types, Tirupuhal. So many things you can do at the end. After the main piece, you can do all that. And if I have a mridangist, I have to give, he will also play a Tani Avartanam after the main piece. And in this way, the concert goes. So concert can be big or small, depending on the availability of time. Again, Carnatic music, important thing is, how do you learn the Carnatic music? That is a very interesting subject. You all must be knowing, it used to be from the Gurukula system. People used to go to the Guru's house and stay there, and they grow up there listening to music, whatever they teach, whenever they teach, they take it from the Guru and then practice. There will be no notes, nothing to write about. Everything has to go to the memory. Whatever you can recall, you recall. Or again, ask the Guru and the Guru will tell you. So that is the thing. So it used to take years to get one song, but once you master a song, it is forever. Permanently it was there. So this was going on for some time till paper was invented. Then printing press came. Yeah. And then they started printing the script. Whatever I learned, let me write it down. So everything evolved from many, many centuries back. Then you come to the notation and the script. Notation in the sense, Shakti Sahita Ganapatim. If I say, what is a swaram? If I ask you, how will you play? Where will I find out Shakti? Where is Sahita? There is a swaram for it. Ga, 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 ma, ga, ri, sa, ri, sa. If you play that, you will get the same tune as Shakti Sahita Ganapatim, like that. It's called notation. Notation writing and then printing it in the books. Books, then after some time, the radio, the television. There are so many evolution that has taken place in the last 100 years or so. So you all know about it, cassettes, CDs and other things. Now what do we have? What do we follow now? So everything is found in this. If I lose this, my life also, I won't know my name also. It's like that. It's more in this now, all capsuled in that. And who is the guru now? Very good. So one thing is good. All of us have the same guru. It's not different teachers now. Universal Guru is only one for all over the world. That's something great. It has brought us all together. So that's a very interesting thing. So, yeah, you can participate in this. I have just written something. There used to be one guru. Now how many? Multiple gurus. Okay. Now the students are at freedom to go to any guru they want. Suddenly they can come to me also. Ma'am, teach me. I liked your music today. You become my guru. And tomorrow another teacher will come. Please, you become my teacher. I will go to her. In this way, you can have multiple gurus. Today's world is like that. Then there used to be one location. There, the guru's house only they will go. Now multiple locations. Listening through ears, Karna Parampare, they say. Whatever the teacher, you have to absorb and then replicate it. Now, now what? Earphones. Use of human memory. Now, Memory in the laptop is there now. Then learning face to face was very important. I will have to see the guru looking at my face, looking at his eyes, ears, everything. Now, Facebook or only face is seen, no? Zoom or whatever you do, only face. Again, same thing only, face to face only again. Concert duration, 3-4 hours. Now, 3-4 minutes, seconds. I listen to one YouTube. No, it's not good. Go to the next. It can be even 1 minute also, less than 1 minute. So this is our attention span now. I don't know why we have become so, going from one to the other. We are not stuck in one place. We are not focused in one art form. We want many art forms. So many changes have taken place. It is taking place. God knows next time when I come for a lecture, what other changes would have happened, we don't know. Notation, script, books. So we have books, notebooks to refer. Now it is Carnatic.com. For Carnatic music, I know. The one place to go is Carnatic.com and see the notation. So in this way, lot of changes have happened, but I'm very happy that you people wanted to know about this art form and the value of this art form, how it was before, how it is now, and even now, it's not late that we can change ourselves. We can change and get focused and learn one art properly, go to one guru, sincerely try, practice, and make use of our time. So I'm really thinking that all of you will be listening to Carnatic music. Every day listen to one song. Can you do that? Will you do? So to appreciate Carnatic music, see, today I have told you something, and that doesn't mean you are extremely interested from today onwards, from 4 o'clock onwards. It's not like that. You have to hear every day, and then become familiar with that. And become friendly with that. Okay, I have listened so many times. I like this music. If you listen only once, you will not know. How many times you would have listened to one film music and mastered it? Same way. Listening to Carnatic music, there is one very good value also. Music therapy research, they say that listening to Carnatic music makes your mind very calm, stress-free, takes you to the next higher level, spiritual level. That is because it's like a meditation. They say Nada Yoga. All the compositions that you hear are about one God or the other. So you are actually meditating towards God through the music. That way what... Whenever we go to temples, suppose I don't know, I forgot the shloka, some shloka which is some 10 lines or something and I have forgotten, we can start singing that song. So that is more easy. Kamakshi Kamakoti Pita Vasini. That is easy for me rather than telling the 100 Kamakshi shlokas, which is not possible. If I have a book, I will do. But if I can't remember, how do you reach? You reach through songs. You reach through music. And God also likes music. So many of the Vagyakaras have shown the way that to attain moksha, it is through music. That's what they did in their lifetime. They attained mukti through music. So I'll conclude this by saying, according to a Yajnavalkya Smriti, Veena Vadana Tattvajnaha Shruti Jati Visharadaha Talagnya cha prayasena moksha margam niyachati. That is, if one has a good understanding of the Veena and the music with the proper Shruti, Tala and Jati, it is certain to go to the path of moksha or attain liberation from this life. So this is given in all the Vedas and Smritis. And I have told you before, I quoted Tyagaraja Swami also. In many of the Kritis, he has also talked about this. Mokshamu Galada, then Nada Tanumanisham, then Nadalolodai Brahmanandame, it gives you so much happiness. At the end of the day, we want happiness, whatever field we are in. So whatever gives you joy and happiness, we have to do that. And hearing more of music which de-stresses you is better than hearing some music which makes you more stressed up. That is, the research has also proved that. So all the best to all of you for listening to Carnatic music from today at least. I hope you do so. Thank you. So how much time we have?
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your beautiful explanation and demonstration on the saptaswaras, the ragas, importance of shruti, the versatility in compositions, the varieties in veena, and the many wonders of music in itself. You have explained the art and divinity of Carnatic music in an effortlessly simple and gracious manner. Today, you have definitely moved us all with your wonderful performance. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Smt Revathi Sadasivam. request Mr. C. J. Lakshmi, Assistant Professor of Chemistry Department, to honor Smt Revathi Sadasivam, discipline of Smt Revathi Sadasivam.
Thank you, ma'am, for your valuable time and educating us through your words and mesmerizing performance on Veena. Now, I thank our faculty and students of SES Beyond Me for your valuable presence during this auspicious event. I thank our electrical department and maintenance team and director of culture department, Dr. Venkat Ramanan, for making these arrangements on this auspicious event. Thank you to one and all.